أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فهو المهتد، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد، يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. وأشهد أن سيدنا وإمامنا وقائدنا وحبيبنا رسول الله محمد صلى الله وسلم وبارك على هذا النبي البهي وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. يا رب صل على الحبيب محمد واجعله شافعنا بفضلك في غدي، فلقد عرفتك منعما متفضلا، ولذا دعوتك فاستجب لي سيدي. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. ثم أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله تعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أما بعد، عباد الله، اتقوا الله وأصلحوا ذات بينكم. All praise due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the master of the whole universe, and I bear witness openly that there is no God worthy of worship except Allah. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah, and we are sending our blessings and our salutations to all the prophets and the messengers of Allah, starting Adam all the way down to Noah, Abraham, Jesus, Moses, Musa, Isaac, and Joseph, until we reach to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Dear respected brothers and sisters, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our time for his sake, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as he gathered all of us in this masjid as his guests, to gather all of us again on Jannah al-Firdaus with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevate our ranks to reach to the highest levels of Jannah. Allahumma ameen, ya Rabbal Alameen. And it is a great honor and it is my pleasure to speak to you today about one of the most important topics that we have ever spoken about, because it is simply related to our religion, and not only this, it is the fundamental and the essential pillar in our religion. And of course, we know the statement. Of course, we know the main pillar in our religion. But sometimes we forget the virtue. We forget the importance of that pillar. Of course, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the prophets and the messengers with the same statement that I'm talking about. And it has many names in Islam. So you can call it the statement of sincerity, or the statement of negation, or you call it the statement of salvation, you call it the statement of declaration. So we call it the statement of shahada. Simply, I'm talking today about the one that who deserve to be worshipped. I'm talking today about the statement of shahada, the statement of la ilaha illallah. And how about the statement and the virtues and the importance And actually, the secrets of La ilaha illallah. We are Muslims, and we say La ilaha illallah. There is no God worthy of worship. There is no deity worthy of our worship and our submission except Allah, which is something so important, but sometimes we forget. Sometimes we do not pay attention. We do not know the greatness and how much is so vast the virtue of La ilaha illallah. Yes, it is so important, yet it is so neglected. Because we have a lot of people, they don't pay attention to the meaning of La ilaha illallah. And they think it is just a lip service when you say La ilaha illallah. And sometimes we say it without meaning it, without understanding the meaning of La ilaha illallah. And let me tell you something. By the end of the khutbah, you will come to the conclusion that wallahi, if you realize, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided me to the best way so I can deliver what I have in a best manner, you will come to the conclusion that, you know what, I feel regret about each and every second in my life that I did not say La ilaha illallah. I can tell you freely that the key to Jannah is La ilaha illallah. We will never enter Jannah without La ilaha illallah. The key to Jannah is La ilaha illallah. And our actions are the ridges, the key of La ilaha illallah. The ridges of that key. So how could you enter Jannah without having the key, which is La ilaha illallah? La ilaha illallah, it is the statement that Allah had created us for. It is the statement that Allah had sent the prophets, the messengers. Allah had revealed all the books for La ilaha illallah. All the messengers came because of La ilaha illallah. The main and the essential, the fundamental pillar in their mission is to convey La ilaha illallah. I can tell you clearly that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had spent 13 years, 13 years in Mecca, and he stayed 10 years of them. He is talking only about La ilaha illallah. His mission was La ilaha illallah. The prayer, salah, which is the second pillar in Islam, weren't making, like Allah did not make it obligatory except after 10 years of his mission, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Even after salah were made obligatory, he continued, you know, conveying the message of La ilaha illallah. And what does it mean? La ilaha illallah. When you say La ilaha, it is called the statement of negation. You are negating anyone other than Allah. And you say clearly, there is no one worthy of my worship. There is none deserves my submission, my love, and my concern, except Allah. When you say La ilaha illallah, that means I live only for Allah. My life, my own affairs, my family, my soul, my body, my wife, my children, my business, my job, my money, my car, my house, all the affairs of my life has to be submitted to Allah. La ilaha illallah is not just a word. It's our belief, our doctrine, our creed. It is the statement of affirmation, confirmation. It is the statement that will keep you firm on the way of Allah, even on the day of judgment. Allah said, يُثَبِّتُ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِالْقَوْلِ الثَّابِتِ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ. Allah will keep you firm on His way in your life, and even in the transitional period while you are in your grave. Then in the hereafter, Allah will keep you firm. Allah will keep you steadfast because of La ilaha illallah. And what can tell you more about this? That the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had said the best statement I ever said. And not only me, but the previous prophets and the messengers, it was La ilaha illallah. أَفْضَلُ مَا قُلْتُ أَنَا وَالنَّبِيُّونَ مِنْ قَبْلِي La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah is the statement that can make you closer and closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not only to say it once, it's not only to say it in tashahud, in your salah, but you should live with La ilaha illallah. And let me tell you something about the Prophet Musa alayhi salam, the Prophet Moses. One day, and you know that the Prophet Moses has a connection, he had a real and very unique relationship with Allah. He is the only prophet talked with Allah directly. No one before him or even after him reached to that level to talk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directly. Sayyiduna Musa alayhi salam, one day while he is talking with Allah, had a special conversation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know what? He said to Allah, Oh Allah, I need you to teach me something. I need you to grant me a statement that I can remember you well. But I need that statement to be special for me, to be customized only for me. I need something very unique. So Allah said to Musa alayhi salam, if you wanted something very unique, say, La ilaha illallah. Sayyiduna Musa said, Ya Rab, everyone say, La ilaha illallah. Everyone knows La ilaha illallah. I need something so special. It seems like he did not understand fully the meaning and the concept and the unique of that statement. So Allah said, Oh Moses, do you know if the whole seven heavens and all the earth and what it contains were placed in one scale, and the word of La ilaha illallah at the next or the other end of the scale, the La ilaha illallah will be heavier in the scale more than the seven heavens and the earth and what it contains. So the best statement ever is La ilaha illallah. It can tell you how many minutes, how many hours, how many days that we have wasted without saying La ilaha illallah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, من كان آخر كلامه لا إله إلا الله دخل الجنة. Who had the last statement in his life was لا إله إلا الله, he will enter Jannah. And the hadith that I shared with the brothers today early after Fajr prayer, that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and this hadith was narrated by Imam Muslim in his Sahih, so it is authentic hadith. He said, I was trying to intercede to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and every time I'm seeking the intercession, Allah is granting me the intercession, till the point that I said to Allah, Oh Allah, grant me the intercession for each and every one would say La ilaha illallah. Allah said, Oh Muhammad, that is not for you. And that is not for anyone. It is only for me. And no one, I swear by my majesty, no one will say La ilaha illallah except that I made the hellfire to be forbidden for him. The hellfire will not touch his body. So you will not only enter Jannah, but you will be saved from the hellfire. Because if we said La ilaha illallah, you will enter Jannah, that could be, after a short time in the hellfire, then you will be moved to Jannah. No, the one who says La ilaha illallah, Allah had forbidden the hellfire to be closer to him. That is La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah, one of the secrets of La ilaha illallah, that if you said with sincerity and you mean it, it can save you from the hellfire. La ilaha illallah is not only lip service. And you know what? One of the things that the scholars said, if somebody is dying and he cannot even move his lips because of sickness, he can still say La ilaha illallah without moving his lips. It is the statement that you can say without moving your lips, just your tongue from inside. So if somebody is dying, he could say La ilaha illallah without moving his lips. Try it. Try to say La ilaha illallah and you do not need to move or to close your lips. It is the statement of sincerity. That is why you memorize Surah Al-Ikhlas. قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ اللَّهُ الصَّمَدُ لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ Why it is called the Surah Al-Ikhlas, the chapter of sincerity? Because it is the manifestation of La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah is the statement of salvation. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the blessings of La ilaha illallah and give us the ability to live while we are saying La ilaha illallah and to die while we are saying La ilaha illallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala resurrect all of us while we are saying La ilaha illallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability to achieve the requirements of La ilaha illallah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العلي العظيم لي ولكم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا وإمامنا وقائدنا وحبيبنا رسول الله محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. لا إله إلا الله. لا إله إلا الله أخلو بها وحدي. لا إله إلا الله ألقى بها ربي. لا إله إلا الله أدخل بها قبري. لا إله إلا الله أدخل بها جنة ربي. We should live for La ilaha illallah. Our priority has to be La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah means the total submission, surrender, the total love, the total sincerity has to be only for Allah. La ilaha illallah has to be in your life. Allah comes first. And everything that you are doing in your life has to be for Allah. I am eating to have the health so I can worship Allah. I am working to get halal money so I will please Allah. I married because I wanted to form, I wanted to establish a Muslim family to please Allah. I am living my life for Allah. I am giving the charity, helping the poor and needy for the sake of Allah. I am coming to the masjid for Allah. I am going to my work for the sake of Allah. Listen to what Allah said in the Quran. قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ. My salah, my rituals, my life, even my death, for the sake of Allah. We came here to this life to worship our Creator. And we should submit ourselves fully, completely to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it's not just a word. It's not just a statement. You say, La ilaha, there is no God. No one. It's a negation. No one will take my total love. No one will have my full concentration and contemplation except Allah. Is to live for Allah. That's the main meaning, the main theme of La ilaha illallah. And let me tell you, I will end by this. But I wish that would be my gift to you on the day of Jumu'ah. And then you will take the correct meaning for the hadith of Rasulullah. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had spoken about a person, and that will happen to him on the day of judgment. And that person, Allah, when he stands before Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will spread out for him 99 sheets, 99 files, 99 scrolls, and they are as far as I can see. Huge files. And all of them are full of sins, are full of bad deeds. Then Allah will ask him, Oh my servant, did you make all of these bad deeds? And he would say to Allah, Yes, Allah, I made it. And Allah would say, Do you think that my angels who wrote all these deeds, do you think that they missed something? He would say to Allah, No, they did not. Then Allah would say, Do you think that you were oppressed by having all these bad deeds? Do you think that somebody oppressed you? He would say to Allah, No, I regret, I acknowledge, I admit that I made all these bad deeds. So he would think that he is going to the hellfire. Then Allah would say to him, You know what? You have something left. You have something that we have kept for you. Then Allah will issue for him a little and small card. Then that card will be placed on the scale. And on the other hand of the scale, the 99 files. So the servant of Allah will say, Oh Allah, what can the little card will do in comparison of the 99 files? It will do nothing. What I have here on this card. So once the angels place the card will be heavier in the scale than the 99 files. So he would say to Allah, What is in this card? Allah would say, It is La ilaha illallah. You have said it once in your life with sincerity, and I have kept it for you. Then Allah will order the angels to to take him to Jannah. That is La ilaha illallah. Think about how many minutes, how many hours that we have wasted in our life without saying La ilaha illallah. But that does not mean that I can do whatever I want and I said it once and that's it. No. It tells you about the mercy of Allah, of course, but you need to achieve La ilaha illallah. You need to live while you are applying La ilaha illallah. As I told you, La ilaha illallah is the key and the bridge and the deed. For that key is your action. How to prove that you love Allah? How to prove that you only worship Allah? I can tell you freely, freely. We have people, they say from their mouth, La ilaha illallah. And I am 100% sure that they love Allah. But when it comes to the actions, no. No, they are doing the opposite. You find salah, the adhan is calling, Hayya salah, and he is sleeping. But at the time of work, he adjusts his alarm to wake up, very active, energetic. Why? Because it's the work, he has money, but for Allah, he is so lazy. Can you tell me, is that is the person who is worshiping Allah? When you say La ilaha illallah, you need to mean it. When you say La ilaha illallah, you need to live with La ilaha illallah. The priority is Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our deeds. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability to achieve the requirements of La ilaha illallah. Please say La ilaha illallah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, قولوا La ilaha illallah تفلحوا. Say La ilaha illallah and you will be succeeded. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive our sins, the minor sins and the major sins. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shower all of us with His mercy. Jazakumullahu khairan, barakallahu feekum, Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana, wa israfana fi amrina, wa thabbit aqdamana, Allahumma tawaffana muslimin, wa alhiqna bis-salihin, wa ahshurna ya rabbana fi zumrati khayr al-mursaleen. Allahumma ya rabbana, irzuqna an nuhaqqiqa ma'na la ilaha illa Allah. اللهم يا ربنا ارزقنا الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل. اللهم باعد بيننا وبين النار كما باعدت بين المشرق والمغرب. اللهم توفنا مسلمين. اللهم اجعل آخر كلامنا من الدنيا لا إله إلا الله سيدنا محمد رسول الله. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. وأقم الصلاة. قوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله.